हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द थ्योरी एंड कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम लैब। फर्स्ट वन इज इंट्रोडक्शन। इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ डेटाबेस। डेटाबेस इज एन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड कलेक्शन ऑफ डेटा सो दैट इट कैन बी ईजिली एक्सेस्ड एंड मैनेज्ड। वी कैन ऑर्गेनाइज डेटा इन टू टेबल्स, रोज, कॉलम्स एंड ऑल्सो इंडेक्स इट टू मेक इट ईजियर टू फाइंड रिलेवेंट इन्फॉर्मेशन। द मेन पर्पज ऑफ डेटाबेस इज टू ऑपरेट ऑन अ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन बाई स्टोरिंग, रिट्रीविंग एंड मैनेजिंग डेटा। मॉडर्न डेटाबेस आर मैनेज्ड बाई द डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम लाइक MySQL, Oracle, MongoDB, SQL Server, etc. Next is introduction of DBMS. DBMS stands for Database Management System. It is a software which is used to store and retrieve the database. Examples are Oracle and MySQL and many more. It provides the interface to perform various operations like creation, deletion, modification, etc. It allows user to create their database as per their requirement and also contain group of programs which acts according to the user instruction. It also provides security to the database. Next part is introduction of SQL. SQL stands for Structured Query Language, which is used for storing, manipulating and retrieving data stored in relational database. Why SQL is used? The answer is that it allows user to describe and access data in relational database systems and also allows user to define the database and manipulate that data. It is embedded in other languages using SQL modules, libraries and precompilers. It allows user to create drops, database and tables, and also to create view, store procedures, functions in a database. It also allows user to set permissions on tables, procedures and views. Next part is SQL constraints. SQL constraints are used to specify rules for the data in a table. They are used to limit the type of data that can go into a table. It ensures the accuracy and reliability of data in a table. There are following constraints which commonly used in SQL. First one is not null, which ensures that a column can't have a null value. Next is unique constraint, which ensures that all values in a column are different. Next is primary key, which is a combination of not null and unique and ensure that every row in a table is uniquely identified. Next is foreign key, which uniquely identify a row or part in another table. The check constraints ensure that all values in a column satisfy a specific condition. Default constraints sets a default value for a column where no value is specified. Index constraint is used to create and retrieve data from database very quickly. Next part is introduction of different type of DDL, DQL and DML commands. First one is DDL. That stands for Data Definition Language, which actually consists of SQL commands that can be used to define the database schema. Some of the examples of DDL commands are given below. First one is create. The create statement is used to create the database and its objects like table, index, function, view, store processors, etc. This is the syntax for creating table. There are two creating table and database. And this is the example to create a table in a database. Next is drop statement. Drop is used to delete objects from database. Here two syntax and two examples are given for drop command. First one is for table and second one is for database. Next is alter command, which is used to alter the structure of database. This is the syntax for alter command and example. Next syntax and next example. We can add columns to any table by using alter command and also drop any column by using alter command. Next is truncate. It is used to remove all records from a table, including all spaces allocated for the records are removed. This is the syntax for truncate command and this is the example for truncate command. Next is comment. Comment is used to add comment to the data dictionary. Example of comments is this. Next command is rename. Is used to rename an object existing in a database. This is the syntax for rename command and this is the example of rename command. Next is DQL, data query language. The purpose of DQL command is to get some schema relations based on the query passed to it. Example of DQL is select statement. The select statement in SQL is used to retrieve or fetch data from a database. The data returned in is stored in a result table that is called result set. And this is the syntax 1 for select statement, and this is syntax 2 for select statement. This is example 1 for select statement, and this is example 2 for select statement respect to their syntax. Next is DML, stands for data manipulation language. The SQL commands that deals with the manipulation of data present in databases belongs to the DML, and this include most of the SQL commands. Example of SQL commands are given. First one is insert. Insert is to statement of SQL is used to insert a new row in a table. There are two ways for using insert into statement for inserting rows. First one is only value, and second one is column names and values both. This is the syntax and example for only values, and this is the syntax and example for column and name values. Next is update statement. The update statement in SQL is used to update the data of an existing table in a database. We can update single columns as well as multiple columns using update statement as per our requirement. This is the syntax for update statement, and this is the example. Next is delete statement. Delete statement in SQL is used to delete existing records from a table. We can delete a single record or multiple records depending on the condition we specify in the where clause. This is the syntax, and this is the example of delete statement. Thank you so much.